When I first heard about Citric acid-based CO2 systems, I thought it's kind of gimmicky and isn't worth my attention. You know, mixing ingredients sounded like DIY and I simply ignored it. But then, positive reviews, one after another, started to show up. And when I heard Aqua owner saying his system produced CO2 for 100 days straight, I thought it was worth having a look myself. In addition, the channel sponsor ARKA has launched their version of the system and challenged me to make a brutally honest review. Quick disclaimer, ARKA is the sponsor of this video, but they don't get to see the video prior release and they don't get any input on this video's production. Actually, they told me not to try and make the chemical reaction visible, which I'm 100% going to do. So in today's video, I'm going to assemble the ARKA myScape CO2 system and compare it with a commercial CO2 kit. But before we open the box, I would like to explain how the system actually works, and I promise to keep it very, very simple. So there is two components, baking soda and citric acid. Look, they are even on the ingredient list of this vitamin C supplement. When mixed with water, both components react into sodium citrate, carbon dioxide, and water. In case of the supplement, the reaction helps dissolve the ingredients in water, making it fizzy and chilled. Okay guys, now with the theory out of the way, let's have a look inside the box. So, this is everything you get in the box, and I would say ARKA has you fully covered. So I would say without any further ado, let's just, kind of quickly go over the things and then put everything together so it can start working and I can show you how easy the entire process is. Actually, one thing I would like to point out right away, from the unboxing already, from the process, the regulator feels so solid, it is so heavy. So the stainless steel version is definitely a premium here. And yeah, everything else, you just get a lot of spare parts, you know, rubber seals, this quick connection mount for the tubing, Allen key, all kind of, you know, those dry beads that go in this device here. So before I ramble too much, let's put it all together. You have a nice and very simple to understand manual. Step one, you connect this one and this one. Let me just peel off the lid here. And then you just screw in those dry beads inside. By the way, it's worth having a look inside the dry beads. This is the regular size. Later on, it is described, you have to check them when you refill the system. If they get some moisture, they will increase in size, and then you have in this little pouch some replacement dry beads. So that is snug and tight in place. What is then? Putting the materials inside the container. Okay, so we have the container here and the components are going inside. So material A and material B. We have a little funnel here to minimize the dirt on the table. And just going to cut off one edge and then pour the stuff inside. That was the citric acid. Now comes the baking soda, component B. Okay, everything is inside. Now the only thing is missing to pour in the water. Tilt the bottle 45 degrees, like this. Should be approximately 45 degrees. Keep this nearby to screw it inside. And then the water. In my case, it's the big bottle. I use 600 grams of each component. And now it's 900 milliliters of, I'm using just cold tap water. So let's put it inside. Okay, so far so good. Oh yeah, I can hear the sizzling. Now let's screw on top the regulator. Nice and tight. Okay. And now you're supposed to give it a little shake. Kind of swirl the components inside the bottle so they mix up evenly. And this is it. I'm done. You know, you could check the time. I can see the time recording. That's literally 5 minutes. With, you know, even fiddling around. So it's done. Now you can keep watching here. The pressure is already going up. So what else are we supposed to do? Step number four, adding water and inserting the bubble counter, which also has a tiny, tiny built-in solenoid. Just look at it, how small that is. Super cool little device. And what's kind of cool about it, it has this quick connector up here. So it. You just insert it and it holds there. Let's open it up at the top and add some water. I have a little syringe. That's maybe the only thing that's not included in the box. So ARKA, you're watching this, make a little syringe included to fill up the bubble counter, because other than that, I haven't been missing anything so far. I'm gonna just use water from my UNS 60U aquarium. Okay, by the way, if you see water evaporating in the bubble counter, this is because the CO2 gas is very, very dry and it just picks up moisture. So basically the water inside the bubble counter evaporates over time. I've seen people using glycerin, which makes the bubble going up super slow. But I've also been reading people having issues with glycerin where it kind of goes through the tubing and gets into the aquarium, which can cause some problems. Let me know, are you team water or team glycerin in the bubble counter? Okay, the bubble counter is all set up, and step number five tells we have to wait 10 to 24 hours. But basically, guys, you see here, we get some, what's it called? I don't know, like moisture in the bottle, because it's getting really cold because of the chemical reaction that is happening inside. And I'm gonna show you the chemical reaction just in a second. And we already have pressure, so if we give power to the solenoid, it's going to open it, and then we can, yeah, see already the first bubbles rising up. So let's do that, so I can show you how quickly this reaction happening. So basically, I could start using it already right now. The only thing that would not recommend doing so is that as long as the pressure is not to a, you know, final stage, the bubble rate can change. So that's why it is advised to wait for 24 hours until next day, when the pressure is where it should be, somewhere around 40. We already are halfway through. That goes super quickly, because then you have the working pressure stabilized and it's not gonna change much for the next like 100 days or so. And then you can fine tune your bubble rate, because if I do the bubble rate right now, it's gonna change until tomorrow because the pressure in the bottle is changing as well. But I would like to see it working, so let's connect the pieces together. I need power. Where do I have power? Yay, under the table we have some power, nice. The bubbles are coming out, the system is already working. By now, it's just spare parts, non-return valve, CO2 proof tubing that looks sturdy, and a little screw for, I don't know, disassembling things when you want to replace them and do the maintenance. We're not getting into that. Everything is explained in this manual, how you can do maintenance on it. Maybe I will do a follow-up when my system runs out and I have to refill it. But you also get a little tiny diffuser in here in the package. So that's definitely not the best quality diffuser here. So if there is something I would complain about, it's this diffuser. And I would definitely not recommend using it with this stiff CO2 proof tubing, because yeah, you get it on top and then to remove it for cleaning or whatever purpose, it's gonna be really, really difficult. I would say we are done here at this point. And yeah, I was actually curious if I would have to wear my glasses. But yeah, so far all good. Super easy to assemble. I would say that's like beginner proof. No need a science degree to do that. And now let's dive in into the chemical reaction and see what is actually happening inside the bottle, because you cannot look inside. It's getting really cold on the outside and you have a little bit of condensation here, some moisture on the outside. So I really want to look inside. Okay guys, but before we get to the fun part, let me do a quick comparison with a commercial CO2 kit to find which one is better. The ARKA CO2 system is not only looking really cool with a stainless steel body, but comes with everything included you need for CO2 injection. The system has a built-in solenoid that allows to turn off the CO2 at night, a needle valve and a bubble counter that allows to dial in the exact amount of CO2 bubbles per second. It has CO2 proof tubing, a diffuser and a bunch of replacement parts and of course the chemical components for the first fill. Everything included and the price is only 119 euros on Amazon. On the other side, cheapest commercial CO2 kit with similar accessories is 175 euro. Now, someone might argue that a commercial CO2 bottle will last longer, and yeah, it's true. A 2 kg bottle at 1 bubble per second and 8 hours per day will last approximately 6 months. The refill at my LFS is 30 euros and the refill for the ARKA is only 10 euros for 2 months. You calculate down per month and you get the same 5 euro per month in both systems. So from a financial standpoint, the ARKA system is a steal. But also design-wise, it easily outperforms the most CO2 kits on the market, and I have to admit my initial concerns about mixing the ingredients are all gone. It only took about 5 minutes to fill the bottle, and getting a refill for a pressurized system will take me at least 1 hour depending on how much traffic is on the road. And while it sounds like a clear winner, I also have a few points on the negative side. I don't like the glass diffuser that's included in the box and that the CO2 tubing has print on it. A drop checker is available separate, yes, but in my opinion it is essential for beginners and should be included in the kit. All in all, I think this might be the best CO2 system for beginners and for everyone having difficulties to refill their CO2 bottles. And now let's get straight to the visual experiment. I would like to see what is actually happening inside the CO2 bottle, would like to make the reaction visible. However, there is one thing I'm not going to do, and this is a disclaimer or a warning, better to say, the cap. Don't put the cap on the bottle, because this PET bottle can only hold, I checked online with Wikipedia, up to 20 bar. The pressure goes up to 40 bars in the CO2 bottle. In this stainless steel bottle, and it's definitely more than this bottle can hold, and then it's going to burst and we don't want to have the mess around. So don't put the cap on top if you are about to repeat this experiment. Now comes the baking soda. Now comes the water. There is the chemical reaction. We have quite a nice chemical reaction going on here. Now you see, and the bottle is getting cold, really cold. So this is what's happening inside the stainless steel bottle with the citric acid and baking soda. Now that you know everything about the ARKA CO2 system, there is actually one important part missing. Even the best CO2 system is only as good as the CO2 diffuser. So watch this video next to see what makes the best CO2 diffuser even better.